गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग अ पोयम क्रिस्टाबेल पार्ट वन एंड दिस इज द लेक्चर 14. इन दिस वी विल बी डूइंग द कंक्लूजन. जो टेक्स्ट है पोयम का वो हम पूरा कर चुके हैं. 12 लेक्चर्स हैं टोटल क्रिस्टाबेल पार्ट फर्स्ट के. ओनली पार्ट फर्स्ट इज इन आवर सिलेबस. पार्ट टू इज ऑल्सो देयर बट वी डोंट हैव टू डू दैट बिकॉज इट इज़ नॉट इन आवर सिलेबस. ये लेक्चर 13 है. इन दिस वी विल बी डूइंग द कंक्लूजन विच इज गिवन बाई द पोएट एट द एंड ऑफ द पोयम of Christabel part first. So in this we'll be doing the conclusion. The poet says, it was a lovely sight to see the lady Christabel when she was praying at the oak tree. At the initial stage of the poem, जब poem की शुरुआत हुई थी तो क्या था कि Christabel goes to the forest. वो रात में forest में जाती है pray करने के लिए. oak tree जो होता है उसके नीचे वो जा करके pray करती है. So the poet says that it was a very lovely sight, it was a very pleasant sight to see when Lady Christabel went to the forest and was praying under the old oak tree. Amid the jagged shadows of mossy leafless boughs, kneeling in the moonlight to make her gentle vows. Here the poet says that it was a, he gives the scene. वो पूरा जो atmosphere था तब का वो वहाँ उसका description देते हुए poet कहता है, amid the jagged shadows because it was a starry night, it was a full moon night as you can remember from the starting of the poem. तो shadow पर रही थी पेड़ की, oak tree की, on the ground where Christabel was kneeling down, of mossy leafless boughs, there was no leaf on the ट्री. एज यू कैन रिमेंबर जो ओल्ड ओक ट्री था उसके ऊपर कोई भी क्या है पत्ते नहीं लगे हुए थे. तो इट वॉज लीफलेस. बाउज मीन्स जो बिल्कुल ट्री के द ब्रांचेज एंड ऑल दैट एरिया जो होता है वहाँ पर कोई भी बाउज. बाउज मीन्स गुच्छे जिसे कहते हैं पर्टिकुलरली. तो इट वॉज लीफलेस, इट वॉज ओनली जस्ट स्टिक्स एंड वुडन स्टिक्स वर देयर, द वुडन स्टेम्स वर देयर ऑफ मॉसी. Though there were no leaves, but it was full of moss. Moss is what? Algae. जो कि पेड़ों के तनों के ऊपर और branches के ऊपर जो लग जाते, तो it was algae was present over there, over the oak tree, and there was no leaf. It was a leafless tree. Kneeling in the moonlight to make her gentle vows. She and it was a full moonlight, or she went to the oak tree and then she knelt down. वो kneel होकर के नीचे बैठी to make her gentle vows. Vows means prayers. To make her gentle prayers beneath the tree. Her slender palms together pressed, heaving sometimes on her breast. Slender palms means palms means हथेलियाँ. Slender weak. Or very gentle. Her slender palms together pressed. Pressed means pressing, as you know that in a the praying position. She was kneeling down and she was in the prayer. She was in the position of praying. So she was pressing her both her palms together. उसने अपनी दोनों हथेलियों को जोड़ लिया pray करने के लिए. Heaving sometimes on her breast and her both the palms were sometimes as she was breathing. She was breathing heavily. She was a bit fearful because earlier she had dreamed that something bad is going to happen with her fiancé, and therefore she came here to make prayers for his well-being. So she was breathing. Heaving means breathing a bit heavily, and in that process her palms, which were pressed together, both her palms, she make them come near to her heart. Her face resigned to bliss or bale. Her face, oh call it fair, not pale. Her face, she was a very this Christabel, she was a very fair lady, and her call it fair, not pale. Her face was not pale, it was fair, and both blue eyes more bright than clear, each about to have a tear. And she has eyes which of blue color, more bright than clear, that was shining very, both her blue colored eyes were shining very brightly, each about to have a tear. And she was very sad, and it was looking as if she can cry anytime, ki wo kabhi bhi ro degi. Why she'll cry? Because of her dream. Because she a bad, very bad dream about her fiance came to her that something bad is going to happen. So for his well-being she came here in this dark forest and in the full moonlight to pray under the oak tree. So as she was in a very sad mood, so it was appearing that she can cry anytime. With open eyes, ah, woe is me, asleep and dreaming fearfully dreaming. Now, in the first para is an expression of the starting of the poem, when we witness Christabel for the very first time when she went to the forest. That time, she was a gentle young maiden, and she went to the forest to pray for the well-being of her fiance. You know, so that whole scene was very, it was a very lovely sight. The poet says it was a very lovely sight. That scene was very lovely, very pleasant to see. But now in the second para deals with the present condition of the Christabel when she is in bed with Geraldine. She meets Geraldine and she takes her along with her home and she takes Geraldine along with her to her home and then to her bedroom, and now she is lying together on her bed with Geraldine. So the second para deals with this situation, the current situation. With open eyes, ah, woe is me. Woe is me. Woe means misery, despair, sadness. So this is my sadness. With open eyes, asleep. Christabel, here the poet is giving the description of the spell under which Christabel is. Geraldine has made a spell over Christabel. She has taken control over her speech, and she has casted her spell. She had put magic on Christabel. Okay? So now Christabel is under her control. With open eyes asleep. She is asleep with open eyes. क्योंकि उसने उस पर जादू कर दिया ना. Geraldine has casted her spell over Christabel. So she is asleep. Means she is not conscious. She is totally asleep with open eyes. As if she is so much bewildered. Christabel is sleeping with open eyes and dreaming fearfully. Fearfully dreaming yet. I wish. And it is appearing that she is dreaming so fearfully. Fearfully dreaming means this figure of speech is metaphor. Because it means that she is having very fearful, frightening dreams. Now what will happen to her? What bad will happen? And all these things. She is getting very frightful dreams. Yet I wish, dreaming that alone, which is oh sorrow and shame. Can this be she? Now the poet asks that what happened to Christabel? What is the current? Poet is feeling so pitiful. उसको क्रिस्टाबेल की अब जो कंडीशन है, प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन है, प्रेजेंट कंडीशन है, उसके ऊपर क्या है, उसको बहुत दया. ही इज हैविंग सो पिटी दैट व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू हर नाउ. जब इसको हमने स्टार्टिंग में देखा था तब ये कितनी प्यारी थी, कितना अच्छा साइट था वो. जब ये प्रे करने के लिए जा रही थी, इससे झलक रहा था कि कितनी ज़्यादा प्योर है और कितनी अच्छी है, कितनी मासूम है, ये सारी खूबियाँ इनके जनक. नाउ व्हाट हैज़ हैपन टू हर, व्हाट इज़ अ करेंट सिचुएशन दैट शी इज स्लीपिंग. वो सो रही है लेकिन वो खुली आँखों से सो रही है ऐसा लग रहा है, क्योंकि उसकी आँखें खुली हुई. दिस इज़ नॉट द थिंग दैट शी इज स्लीपिंग, शी इज़ एक्चुअली अंडर द स्पेल. वो बिल्कुल जो है जेरल्डाइन का जो जादू किया हुआ है क्रिस्टाबेल के ऊपर, वो उसके कंट्रोल में है. और उसको बुरे जो है उसको दुस्वप्न आ रहे हैं, बुरे सपने आ रहे हैं. ड्रीमिंग दैट अलोन, और वो भी क्या है, सपने भी उसको क्या है, अकेले आ रहे हैं. शी इज़ ऑल अलोन नाउ, ऑल अंडर द स्पेल ऑफ जेरल्डाइन. वो बिल्कुल उसके वश में हो चुके हैं और वो बिल्कुल अकेली है. विच इज़ ओ सॉरो एंड शेम. दिस सिचुएशन इज सो बैड. सॉरो मीन्स sad. The situation is very sad, full of sorrow and shame. It is full of shame also that now she is in such a condition with Geraldine, which she cannot tell to anyone. You know, the sexual imagery which the poet has presented in the last part of the poem, that this is a situation full of shame. Can this be she? Ki kya Christabel ye vastav mein ho sakti hai? The lady who knelt at the
old oak tree. So poet here presents a very he is so confused himself. The poet is so he is full of despair himself also. Poet को खुद भी बुरा लग रहा है कि that can this be she, क्या क्रिस्टाबेल वास्तव में ये हो सकती है, the lady who knelt at the old oak tree, जो कि पुराने वो oak tree जो है उसके नीचे वो prayer करने गई थी, और अभी जो लेडी इस कंडीशन में है, क्या ये दोनों सेम है, क्या क्रिस्टाबेल यही है. एंड लो द वर्क ऑफ दीज हार्म्स दैट होल्ड्स द मेडन इन हर आर्म्स. नाउ द पोइट रेफर्स टू जेरल्डाइन. लो मीन्स लुक, एंड लुक द वर्क ऑफ दीज हार्म्स. हियर दिस फ्रेज इज यूज फॉर जेरल्डाइन. वर्कर मीन्स ड्यू टू विच all these things happened, all these harms, yeah, all these negative things happened with Christabel. Who is the responsible for the situation? This is Geraldine. So the worker of these harms, that is Geraldine, that holds the maiden in her arms. She is holding Christabel in her arms. Geraldine is lying along with Christabel in her bed, and then she is holding Christabel in her arms. Seems to slumber still and mild. As a mother with her child, this lady, this Geraldine, what she had made of Christabel, she has totally changed the state of Christabel, and she is responsible for such a harmful situation, such a sorrowful situation. And look at this lady, look at this Geraldine. She seems to slumber. Slumber means sleep. That she is sleeping still and mild. That without anything, उसको कुछ भी पता नहीं और वो आराम से सो रही है. That she is very still means very calmly. She is sleeping very calmly and mild as a mother with her child. And it is appearing that she is sleeping with Christabel as if she is sleeping with her child, as if a mother sleeps with her child without any care, without anything. That when a mother sleeps with her child, obviously शी इज़ होल्डिंग हर चाइल्ड. वो अपने बच्चे को, माँ जो है बच्चे को पकड़ करके सोती है, और ऐसे सोती है कि वो बच्चा जो है पूरी तरह से उसकी प्रोटेक्शन में है, पूरी तरह कोई भी उसको कुछ आके नहीं कर सकता है, नहीं उठा के ले जा सकता है माँ के पास. उस तरह का मतलब माँ का कंट्रोल होता है बच्चे पे. हियर द पोएट हैज़ प्रेजेंटेड अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल सिमिली इन द कंपेरिजन ऑफ क्रिस्टाबेल एंड जेरल्डाइन्स सिचुएशन टू द सिचुएशन ऑफ अ मदर एंड अ चाइल्ड. कि जैसे माँ जो है वो बच्चे को बिल्कुल अपने प्रोटेक्शन में लेकर के सोती है, उस तरह से जेरल्डाइन जो है वो क्रिस्टाबेल के साथ लेटी हुई है और आराम से सो रही है, एंड उसके ऊपर पूरा अपना क्रिस्टाबेल को पूरी तरह से अपने कंट्रोल में लेकर के जो है वो आराम से सो रही है, एंड क्रिस्टाबेल इज उसकी आँखें खुली हुई है, शी इज स्लीपिंग एंड शी इज हैविंग फियरफुल ड्रीम्स. ठीक है, उसने उसके ऊपर क्योंकि वो जादू कर दिया, उसके ऊपर कंट्रोल कर लिया. ठीक है, तो हियर दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द कंक्लूजन टू द पोयम क्रिस्टाबेल पार्ट फर्स्ट.